a good numerical integration routine, given a function f of x, doesn't ask you to input the grid spacing, decide, you know, how fine the grid should be to get an accuracy. It does it for you. Okay, that would be the MATLAB integral dot m. That's called adaptive quadrature. So I think to complete this section on integration, I have to give you an idea of how a code can figure out what the proper grid spacing is to give you a certain level of accuracy. So we're going to illustrate adaptive quadrature using the trapezoidal rule. I want to integrate the function from a to b of f of x dx. How does it work? Well, you start at, you go from level 1 to level 2 to level 3 until you get the desired accuracy. So what is level 1? So we're going to start at level 1. So basically, we're only going to use 2 points, which are the endpoints of the interval starting. So we integrate from A to B. So on level 1, our grid spacing is just B minus A, right? That will be our H. And the trapezoidal rule will be H over 2 times F of A plus F of B, right? That's the elementary formula for the trapezoidal rule. And then let's look at the error. So the error here will be minus H cubed over 12 times the double derivative, the second derivative, at some point in this interval a to b. So let me just call cosine. Okay? So this is kind of this coming from the Taylor theorem with a remainder. So cosine is some value in a and b. Okay? Still at level 1, we want to compare this integral from a to b to something else. What we do is we compare it from A to C to B. So we place a point C in the middle of the interval and try to compute now using the two elementary trapezoidal rules to compute the integral from A to B. So here, the integral would be now the width here is H over 4 instead of H over 2. And then we would have an F of A using the extended trapezoidal rule, f of a plus 2 times f of c plus f of b, okay? And then we would have two error terms. We would have minus, now it would be h over 2 cubed over 12 times the second derivative of some cosine between a and c, so I'll call that cosine on the left side, minus h over 2 cubed over 12 times the second derivative of f with cosine on the right side. Okay? So we want to know, this is level 1, so it will never work at level 1. But this is what we're going to do iteratively. At level 1, we want to compare these two integrals, okay? So we want to know whether this integral is good enough, this second one is accurate enough. So we can define S1 here is the first integral, is h over 2 f of a plus f of b. And we can define this second integral, S2, is h over 4 f of a plus 2 f of c plus f of b. Okay? Those are our, we're comparing the S1 to S2, but we're also comparing the errors. So the error associated with S1 is this h cubed over 12 f double prime of psi. So we'll say that's minus h cubed over 12 times f double prime of psi. The error in this second integral is this one, but we're going to make an approximation. Here the approximation is not great, but the approximation will get better and better as we move down the levels. Instead of taking psi L and psi right, psi R, let's just say that these are kind of all equal, okay? So these second derivative functions, we'll just say they're all equal. So then the error here would be two of these. We divide through by 8, so then we have a minus 1/4. So minus 1/4 of h cubed over 12. And then just approximate this by f double prime of cosi. Okay? So here it's not going to be quite accurate because we have the second derivative somewhere in AB, and here we have the second derivative somewhere in AC and somewhere in CB. But as these intervals get smaller and smaller, this sort of approximation will be okay. So the error here is 1/4 of E1, right? So E1 is 4 times E2, right? E1 here is 4 times E2. As you would expect, right? The finer the interval, then the smaller the error is. So we have this relationship then that S1 plus E1, this is actually the integral, is equal to S2 plus E2, that's also the integral, and that E1 is 4 times E2. So finally, we would get, so if E1 is 4 times E2, we would get S1 plus 4 times E2 equals S2 plus E2. So we get an estimate for the error. We say that the error then, right, or if we want the absolute value of the error, 3E2 equals S2 minus S1, S2 minus S1 divided by 3. Okay? This is the key to adaptive quadrature. By doing this integral at level 1 twice, once from A to B, and then the second time from A to C and from C to B, we can get a handle on what the error is in the integral. So the error is going to be the difference between S2 and S1, these two integration formula, divided by 3. We're going to be comparing then E2 against the maximum error that we find acceptable. So if E2 is greater than our tolerance, then we're not done. Then we need to go further, okay? So if E2 is greater than tolerance, if E2 is greater than some specified tolerance, then we go to level 2, okay? Level 2 then treats the integral from A to C as one integral, and the integral from C to B as another integral. So here we have the integral from A to C plus the integral from C to B, and treats both of these intervals independently in the same way that we did at level 1. So we take we integrate using the trapezoidal rule here, and then we take a point in the middle, and we integrate using two trapezoidal rules. We compare them and look at the error. And the same on the right interval. So both of these are done independently. And we need the error then to be less than 1/2 the tolerance, because we're summing the errors from the left plus the errors from the right. So we have to keep decreasing the tolerance by 2. And we stop on each time that we've gotten an error smaller than the tolerance. So when you do adaptive integration, you keep you start with a big interval and you keep breaking it up into smaller and smaller intervals. The ones that are easy to integrate, the function doesn't wiggle too much, say, the function is almost a constant, then you finish rapidly. And the stuff where the function might wiggle a lot, you might need to go to finer and finer intervals in order to get your error below your tolerance. Okay, let me summarize. In adaptive quadrature, the numerics itself determines the points that you want to evaluate your function at. You keep going down in levels so that you can have some fine grid spacing where you need it, where the function may vary a lot, might wiggle a lot. And you need very coarse grid spacing where the function may be like essentially constant. So then you don't need very fine grid points. Adaptive quadrature is a fast method. It puts the points where you need them. Integral.m, your MATLAB integrator, uses adaptive quadrature. You don't have to specify your grid spacing. All you do is you specify your tolerance. Or MATLAB also has a default tolerance. So MATLAB can use the default, or you can specify it. I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.